Various approaches exist to create saliency maps, also known as class activation maps or attention maps for 2D images on classification tasks. These maps can help to make deep learning models more interpretable and explainable by showing the areas the model paid most attention to. However, one reason that these kind of techniques aren't used more often is that they are relatively complicated to integrate into one's code base. Especially problematic in a medical setting is that these techniques have only been implemented for 2D data on classification tasks and thus could not be used before with medical data, which is often 3D, nor could it be used for medical segmentation tasks. To solve these problems, we created a lightweight open source PyTorch library called MedCam. MedCam has multiple popular techniques implemented as backends, such as guided backpropagation, GradCam, guided GradCam, and GradCam++. Furthermore, we extended the implementations to be able to handle both 2D and 3D data and models, as well as classification and segmentation tasks. This enables MedCam to be used in many more medical tasks than before. But to be actually usable, we designed MedCam in such a way that it can be used in only two short lines of code. So there is no nasty setup required to integrate MedCam into your code. Moreover, MedCam is well documented and is easy to implement more backends if desired. Here's an overview of the implemented backends. In GradCam, an input image is first propagated through the model. Then a class can be chosen that should be isolated to only obtain the attention of this particular class. This is simply done by setting all gradients computed at the end to zero, excluding the gradients of the desired class. Then those gradients are backpropagated through the model up to a chosen layer. Here the gradients are average pooled, multiplied with the feature maps of that layer and finally passed through a ReLU function. The result is an attention map that shows the model attention at the specific layer for a specific class. Usually, the attention is extracted for the last convolutional layer to get the best compromise between high-level semantics and a detailed spatial information. GradCam therefore works well for generating class-discriminative coarse heat maps. One drawback is, however, that it is not really precise. On the right side, here for example, you can see some results. The first row shows the results for a 2D classification task, the second row for a 2D segmentation task, and the third row for a 3D segmentation task. Another technique that is more precise and fine-grained is guided backpropagation. Here the input image is propagated through the model first, just like in GradCam, where the gradients are computed at the end. Then these gradients are backpropagated to the first layer, while at each layer all negative gradients are set to zero, so that only the positive attention will be computed. The results, as can be seen on the right, are fine-grained attention maps. Drawbacks are, however, that this resulting attention is not class discriminative, nor can a desired layer be selected, like in GradCam. That brings us to the third method, named guided GradCam. This essentially is a combination of guided backpropagation and GradCam to combine the benefits of both techniques. First, the GradCam attention map is generated and then the guided backpropagation one. And then both are combined. This results in a fine-grained class-discriminative attention map that can be generated at a layer of your choosing. The last implemented technique is GradCam++, which works just like GradCam but weights the gradients differently at the end. This results in a better image localization, especially for multiple objects of the same class. Let's give you an example on how to use MedCam. As before mentioned, MedCam can be integrated into your code within just two lines and works with any CNN-based model for 2D or 3D data with a classification or segmentation task. First, you import MedCam. Then you instantiate your model and data loader. After that is done, you inject MedCam into your model with this line. And that's it, you are done. An import and the injection. Now you can do whatever you want to do, as in this case, inference on some new data. Each time, the forward method of your model is called. The for the input corresponding attention maps will be automatically be generated and saved in the above specified output here. The default technique used in MedCam is GradCam and can be changed in the injection call if desired. What happens internally during the injection call is that MedCam adds some functions and variables to your model and replaces your model's forward method with its own. Each time the forward of the model is called, MedCam's forward is actually called, which will handle the generation of the attention maps, but at the same time also calls the model's original forward. The maps are saved automatically and the return value will be the unaltered predictions of your model. This ensures that your model runs without problems and does not crash in case you do post-processing on the predictions or anything else. Besides the backend to use, you can also change the layer from which the attention maps will be extracted and the class for which the attention should be isolated, all in the same injection call. By default, MetCam will automatically choose the last convolutional layer and generate the attention for all classes. MetCam is open source and hosted on GitHub under the following link.